repeating bullet.
If you only knew the power of the dark side.
More powerful than a locomotive.
Hulk! Smash!
Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound.
There's more to them than meets the eye.
It's Superman!
I'm not the one who's so far away when I feel the snake bite and tear my veins. Never did I wanna be here again, and I don't remember why I came.
Yeah.
Hey there, boils and ghouls, Chuckles the Clown, back in the saddle again, as Aerosmith would say, here on Chuckles Crypt, Rhode Island Free Radio. And as always, across the table from me, George Garner. We've had an exciting last couple weeks, and I have to apologize to the listeners once more, probably 5,000 times more within the next couple years. We were off the air for 2 weeks, and well, with good cause, because being an evil clown, you're in the eyes of the celebrities a lot. We had a convention we just came back from, Fairhaven Toy Show. Awesome time. We'll get to sit there and rub elbows with Felix, otherwise Cousin It. It's been really cool. It has really been we had a Revoir Spy book reading, which I did not make it to because I got this diabolic virus you guys were spreading around. For some reason, it still touched the clown, and I don't know how you guys did it, but bravo, you got me on that one.
Well, if it'll make you feel any better, Chuckles, I did commiserate with you guys by watching Stephen King's The Stand. So I didn't have the plague myself last week, but I did sympathize and, you know, did identify with you in that way.
This thing was rotten. It had to have been put out by Satan himself. It had
I did not do that.
It has no cure to it whatsoever. If you had used Pepto-Bismol or any of the other stuff that you could take care of it, it did not work. And it hangs inside your lower intestines for about a week. So just when you think you're done and it's all over, comes back 2 days later, and next thing you know, you're sitting in your bed tied up with the straitjacket. A little toot like that turns to a lot of wetness like that inside the bed. Very devastating disease. Now, on a brighter note, other than devastating diseases, which I do like, and we like to talk about on the Haunted Cabaret, which is coming up.
Except not when it interferes with our broadcast schedule.
No. We got to stick to the comics, and we're going to hit a really good subject tonight, and I hope your listeners are excited for this one. And we will keep the diseases to George Garner's show, The Haunted Cabaret, where all things disease,
that's not, you know,
stay.
I was debating about the topic for this week's show. I think you just gave it to me.
Nasty diseases.
We'll do diseases.
There's a million of them out there. But in our future, less than 2 weeks away, everybody's been waiting for this. I know I have. Avengers 2 in theaters with Age of Ultron. I'm excited for this. You excited to check this thing out?
Well, let's put it this way. The Avengers is one of my favorite movies of all time, and Ultron is just about one of my favorite Marvel villains of all time. So, yeah, go figure.
And you know, I normally would step back and say, you know what, this is really jumping away from the story. But I got to stop doing that, because the movies will never, ever grasp the comic world.
Well, I'm glad you said that, Chuckles, because for many years I struggled with this. And I finally, it was a good day when I came to the realization, and I think it was Stephen King that pointed this out once and for all, just stop it. In other words, the written word and film are two 100% different things. They were, are, and always will be. So we got, you know what I'm saying, we got to channel our brains. Two different things.
It's true. And even the comics themselves, they'll change the stories up as the years pass. 10 years go, certain things will change that you don't like, especially if you, like yourself, if you were an avid Avengers fan, and all of a sudden certain characters end up inside of it that you wouldn't like. Like mine personally, I didn't care for the first time Spider-Man appeared in the Avengers.
That's going back a ways, but I agree with you. That was a mistake.
I'm not a Spider-Man fan. I know I'm going to get hate mail for this.
Well, I'll tell you, I am a Spider-Man fan, and I still didn't like it. You know, some things just kind of like when they put Godzilla, they mixed Godzilla into the Marvel Universe.
Yeah, the Avengers versus Godzilla. I mean, that's happened before. It was the Avengers versus Fing Fang Foom. That was basically Godzilla right there. And we saw what happened with that. Thor ended up turning Fing Fang Foom into his throne.
Well, I think the Fin Fang Foom turned into the Midgards was actually, we found out, and this aggravated me no end. I don't know if, I forget if this was in the Avengers comic or in Thor's own comic, but the Fin Fang Foom apparently was all along an embodiment of the Midgard serpent, which was one of the stupider plot developments that I don't know. I just couldn't live with that one.
There's always these different spins. I mean, sometimes the Mandarin had Fing Fang Foom come out from his powers of the rings or whatnot, and you had the serpent. They never could get a straight answer where this creature came from. Maybe in the newer books, because he hasn't appeared yet. Mm-hmm. Maybe in the newer books, they'll shed some light on this, and they'll finally give him a definite story. That would be a really cool creature for the Avengers to be fighting. We're going to go back to talking a little more about Avengers, but tonight we're also going to enjoy the music. I have a great lineup for you guys. Nurse Misery was the one that took care of the music list because, as we all know, Chuckles the Clown has been spending time in prison. We all know why, too. You guys got me in trouble for my fellow evil clowns out there for doing acts of kindness.
Too many. And I warned you about this quite a while back, if you remember.
Yeah, and I am not allowed on the internet at all, so if you ever see my name going up there, it's usually Nurse Misery, or maybe Deadly Dan got a hold of my secret code there, which isn't really hard. It's I Hate Deadly Dan, so he understands how to get on there, so it's probably one of the two. Let's go down to a song that best describes all of us in this room and anybody that is listening to this show. We're going to go down to Down with the Sickness by Disturbed.
Changes. Oh no, the world is a scary place. Now that you've woken up.